So I'm at Racquet Studios with Simon in your amazing volume stage. We have the new Canon Flex Zoom here. Simon, what exactly is a volume stage and what is virtual production?
Well, virtual production, simply put, is use of a large TV screen such as you have here, high resolution image being portrayed with a camera being tracked, which gives the illusion of being within a real 3D environment.
And that gives you what we call parallax. So as the camera moves, the background moves, and everything feels like a real world. So if you were in something like a forest, and you guys have got some scenes that we've been looking at, and you've built, as the camera tracks, the background tracks with it, and you see the parallax.
Exactly. I mean, as the camera tracks across your scene, you can see round corners into doorways. You get the real sense of being in a physical space.
That's done with tracking, but it also has a thing called a frustum. Do you want to explain what a frustum is?
A frustum is essentially what the camera is seeing, the part of the volume that the lens is pointing at any one time.
What sort of work would you see used on your stage?
This particular stage has been designed really as the kind of a small to mid-sized solution, which is really useful for lots of commercial work, pickup shots, music videos, quite short form content, and smaller scale kind of productions.
So Simon, do you want to talk a little bit about the setup you have here? Because every setup is slightly different. I know this is made up of 144 panels, but talk me through the exact process of how and what you're using here to get this working.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. I think every volume will have a different solution. We use different equipment. But what we're working with here is essentially we're working with the Unreal Engine, the game engine that's driving through NVIDIA cards. That's then feeding into the ZEISS server, which is essentially giving us a heavy processing, heavy rendering power, gives us all of the juice we need to feed onto the wall in real time. That's being distributed by Brompton Processor, which essentially is stitching together all of those 144 tiles and giving us a kind of, really quick processing, which avoids a kind of a tearing of the screen as the camera is moving. So beyond that, we're using an image-based lighting solution in the room here. They're all running through DMX, so they're feeding real-time image-based lighting from the environment, all color with great color accuracy. Yeah.
What do you view is the main benefit of virtual production?
I think it is that convenience.
Yeah.
I mean, I think, people would argue the sustainability point. But I believe that it is, I think it's true. I think, the fact that you are saving on travel, the location-based work is power, resource hungry. Traveling, jumping on aeroplanes is, damaging to the environment, of course. And although these kind of solutions are quite power hungry, I think it doesn't come anywhere close to a traditional set. And of course, you've got that ability to swap out your scenes and swap out your locations with relative ease.
Well, I know you're a bit of a firm believer like me in photogrammetry as background.
Digital twins or replicants of either physical locations or objects.
So also as well with virtual production, everybody talks about pixel pitch. Can cause a moiré. I mean, what I always do is I go and test that combination. You don't need to have it all tracking. You just check the camera and the lens combination on the screens that you intend to shoot on before you use them. And then finally, you're using the Red Spy for the camera tracking.
It's essentially looking upwards, looking at the ceiling, where we have lots and lots of reflective markers. Very, very small, very unobtrusive. That's being paired with an XD unit, which is taking all the data from the lens of the camera and feeding it real time into the engine and into the servers.
And that's what I'm excited about is this new Canon Flex Zoom. This lens is an industry leading T-stop, 2.4. I don't think there's any other lenses.
It's the fastest in the market right now.
In virtual world, it's important that it's that fast because one of the easiest ways to get rid of moiré is to have a shallower depth of fields. Particularly using the Canon glass, I mean, the skin tones, they're fantastic. Less grading time.
And as you said, if you're working within a Canon glass ecosystem, it's going to marry up, it's going to pair well.
I mean, I've shot with fixed lenses a lot in a volume. I mean, the big pain is swinging the lens. It's not like a normal world. When you swing that lens, you've got to upload the calibration. It's not a quick change. So this lens, when it's in Super 35, it's 31.5 to 95, but I think the crucial number is it goes to T1.7. So we've got two protocols, the ZEISS Extended and the Cooke. What's the difference?
So essentially, the Cooke Eye is giving you the core information from the lens. So it's giving you the iris, the zoom, and the focus data. That's sort of the core information. Whereas the ZEISS extended data is giving you more kind of more correction. So correction of distortion and correction of vignetting, etc., which is really useful for kind of set extension work, VFX, etc.
VFX works. And then that combined with the tracker, as we said, via either the PL mount, via the cable, depending on what your camera configuration is. There are inherent problems with encoders.
External encoders, yeah, because essentially you're adding another link in the chain of your workflow.
Yeah.
And because they're, you know, a separate device on the external part of your lens, you know, they can be in sort of inherent with sort of, you know, latency, accuracy, and noise.
And they have to be calibrated every time you use them.
Exactly.
Yeah, I mean, I know, you know, talking to the technical operator here, he was saying that when this lens was set on 45, it's showing 45 inside of Unreal Engine.
Yeah, so precision.
It's precision. There's no drift. It can't drift off.
Yeah.
I mean, I know time code drifts off. So, you know, this is locked. There is no drift off on it.
Exactly. It's more reliable than using a third party device.
And for me, clean. It's clean. I mean, as I said, it's not looking like a Triffid. There aren't cables going everywhere.
Yeah.
You know,
which can easily happen. I mean, you know, once you've built your rig and you've got everything going on there, it can become a real mess.
Yeah,